Hello and welcome back to my Farmer Simulator Giants Edited tutorial. And today I'm going to be having a look at the Sawmill mod. I have a placeable version from the Marhu.net website by Festus. This is the version that's available on the Two Rivers map. I've just wanted to basically have a play around with this and see what it's all about. There are a few different versions. As I say, this one is, I can only assume, what was used on the Two Rivers map. I never actually played that map, but I like this version. It's quite good. Got a few quirky things going on with it, but for the most part, it's actually really nice. So yeah, I've already downloaded it. I'm just going to minimize that now. I've already downloaded it. I'm back on my sample mod map here. So if I just minimize that, you can see I've got it on the desktop there. So I'm going to open up my map folder here, and then I'm going to go into map models, buildings. And then what I'm going to do is copy that and paste it into that folder. And then what I'm going to do is actually shorten it, because that's far too long. Yeah, that's fine. We'll leave it like that. It doesn't matter. Actually, I might change that. Let's call it woodwork. There we go. That'll be fine. Okay, so now that I've changed it, and you can change it to whatever you want to, I'd recommend you change it from the original text length, because that's far too long. When we get into creating path file names and stuff like that, that will become quite frustrating, having to type all of that out with the uppercase, lowercase, underscores and all the rest of it. So if you just change it to something simple that you can remember, that isn't already obviously in the map itself or in that folder. If you wanted to change it, for example, if I wanted to change it to Sawmill, which is more than likely what I would have changed it to, but the fact that it's already in that folder, you could always create your own folder like I have here called Imported, put it into that folder, then call it Imported, and then that will be perfectly fine. But I want, call it Sawmill in that particular folder, but I've gone for this particular route, so, you know, whatever works for you. Okay, so now that I've got that into there, I'm going to reopen my Giants Editor session here. And I'm going to go File, Import, go back to my desktop here, make sure I'm in the right folder, Map, Models, Buildings, and then go to the bottom, Woodwork, and I'm going to click on this i3D here and open it. This will then bring it into the map for me. And I'm going to go Edit, Interactive Placement, and I want to put it somewhere where it's not going to interfere with anything else on the map. I have got a cell trigger somewhere here for the horses, so I don't want it to interfere with that. So what I might do is just drag it across that way a bit. There we go. Okay, so now that I've got that into there, we can have a look at it and see what it's all about. So we've got obviously the logs trigger over here, so you cut your trees down, put your logs in there, they go up onto the rollers, come through the sawmill here, and then get converted into these wood planks, and then they go onto a pallet here, which we can then sell. So that's that. And then on this part of it, we have the outputs. So we would that's an input. That's this one here is your input. So here you would have wheat winrow, barley winrow, or wood chips. This is an output trigger over here for the wood chips. So it can become somewhat self-sustaining if you wish it to. You can collect your wood chips, put them back into the actual input trigger there, and then it will continue to run. So you don't need to add anything like fuel, diesel fuel or anything like that to it. Just put in your either wheat winrow, barley winrow, or your wood chips that this particular unit produces anyway. So yeah, like I say, it can become somewhat self-sustaining if you wish it to. So yeah, that's that. Okay, so we'll go through this as we work on down and try and explain as much as I can. So in the main transform group here, we've got our user attributes window. So if you haven't got that window, user attributes, and then this will pop up. And the only thing I'm there interested in is the actual mod itself. So on create, we've got mod on create, and then fabric script. So that's the script that I need to look for to copy across into my sample mod map script folder or whatever else I decide to do with it, and then create the path file name for that. But we'll get to that as we go. So I'm just going to click on the plus to expand this out a little bit, And inside here, we've got some other parts, input triggers. As you can see, we've got wheat windrow, barley windrow, wood chips, like I said, into that particular area there. Then we've got our halts, which is actually our wood trigger, which is all of our logs. So that would be obviously when you cut down your tree, you put the logs in there and away we go. So that's fine. Then we've got our output triggers. So we have our wood chips, which will come from here. And then we have our board pallets, which will come from here. So first of all, what we need to do here is go into this particular product to click on the plus to expand it again, and we have a pallet spawner. So then if I come down to the user attributes, we have a pallet file name, which is then pointing to boardpallet.o3d. But we need to put in some sort of path file name there so that it can find that particular o3d. So if I go back into the actual folder here, so I'm in map models buildings, and then if I go into my woodworking, what I'm looking for is board pallets, and you can see that just there, or boardpallet.o3d. So if I bring that up, just going to bring down my Giants editor session there so I can actually see that path file name. And I'm just going to type that in now. So map models buildings. Woodwork, and then our actual O3D. So there we go, that should be perfectly fine. So now that I've got that into there, it will locate that O3D for me and then give me my palette and everything else. So fantastic. So that's that part done. Don't need to do anything further there just yet. So the next thing I want to do is come down to my work animations. And if I go into here, we've got a transform group called PS, which would be our particle systems. So just bring that back up so you can see it a bit better. So we've got wood chip, sort emitter, and smoke. So in here, what we need to do is obviously come into our user attributes again, and we have our particle system file name. So we need to point our path file name to these particular particle systems, the O3Ds. So I go back into my map again, into my folder again. We can come into our SegWork folder here, and then we have our PS folder like so. And in here we have our i3ds. So I'm just going to bring down my giant editor session again. So what I need to do is obviously create that path file name. Well, we've got some of it here. We've got the SegWork and the PS, and obviously the actual i3d itself on the end. So what I need to do there is go map models buildings, woodwork, like so. So now that I've got that, I can now highlight all of that and copy it. And then I can go down to the others and just paste that in like so. So I don't have to continually type it each time. Like so, and just double check that that's right. So we've got map, models, buildings, woodwork, SegWork, PS, and then the smoke. So that's perfectly fine. That's okay. They should all now be set up appropriately. So particle systems all set up. Now, one thing I did actually come across while I was doing this as a test sort of thing, just to see how it all went into the map. One thing I did actually find was if you actually look at these particle systems, you can see that all of the others, the actual transform groups, the gizmo is showing on screen here in the appropriate place for the particle system that it's going to be displaying. So we've got smoke, and that is attached to the top of that smokestack. So if I then go inside the building, we click on the saw emitter, you can see it's actually on the saw itself. And then again with this one, you can see it's by the saw itself. So it gives us the appropriate particle animations that we need for that area. Now, if I come back out again and I actually go to the wood chips one is all the way down here under the map. Obviously not right. So we need to have a play around with that and actually get that into the appropriate place, because it needs to be attached to this area here. So what I'm going to do is just bring it up and have a bit of a play around with it. And you will need to do something similar to this if it is indeed what you want it to, if you want it to give you the same effects and get the particle system working correctly and displaying correctly in game. Can be a bit fiddly when you're trying to place the gizmo in the right place here. But just persevere with it and I'm sure it will be fine. And then what you'll more than likely have to do is go into game and then run it, see what it looks like, and then adjust it accordingly. So I'm just going to bring that back out a little bit. Okay, I'm going to leave it there like that for now, and then I will see what that looks like in game. And I probably won't adjust it too much, to be fair, just not for this tutorial, but you'll get the general idea what I mean, that I put it in an area somewhere where I think it might be appropriate. And if it then doesn't look right, you may then have to obviously come back into Giant Serta and move that into the right position to give you the proper wood chips particle system effect that you require. If it doesn't bother you at all, leave it where it was under the map and just ignore the fact that it doesn't have a particle system at all attached to it. But I particularly like the idea of having, you know, I'm going to collect wood chips from here. I wouldn't mind actually seeing them coming out of the spout here or the funnel or whatever you want to call that. But I'll leave that up to you to decide how you want to go about doing that. Okay, so now that I've set all that up like so, I don't need to do too much more in here. I need to put down a cell trigger. But as far as the actual mod itself is set up, one thing I will do just here, I'm going to close that down. I'm going to go into my window, terrain editing. And then what I'm going to do here is go to my terrain sculpt mode. And then what I want to do is I'm going to go put my cursor over the area here. And I'm going to go Control R to actually give me the height of the ground area as I am at the moment. So Control R, and you can see in the replace tab, it's actually changed there to 81.794. So what I'm going to do is get rid of the end numbers there like so, and I've got my left mouse set up to replace. When I click on that, it will actually lower the ground down to 81 and then give me what I need to display the correct area below this tank. And if it doesn't, I can always adjust it accordingly to get what I need. So I'm just going to come around now and lower this down again. We'll just clip through that so I can actually see it properly. Okay. So we'll just lower that down as well. Okay, there we go. So that's that done. So just making sure that I didn't go too far with the tool there and actually lower the ground down outside. We haven't got any massive divots or whatever else. Not bothered about what's going on under the actual mod itself, because if I come down under the mod, you'll see that it's actually been lowered considerably, the ground height, but that's fine. I'm not really bothered about that because the actual base plate of the mod covers that up. So now that I've got that done, it makes it look a little bit better, a bit more realistic, not grass poking through anywhere, so that's fine. So I've done that. Okay, excellent. So the next thing I'm going to do here, I need to actually import a cell trigger. You probably will find that if you're working with a sample mod map, it more than likely has one on it. But this sample mod map, for whatever reason, and I certainly can't find one, I've looked all through all you need transform group here, and I just literally can't find one anywhere in there. There may be one in here, I just haven't been able to find it. So to try and save a bit of time, I've just exported one from another map, and I'm just going to then basically bring one in to this map so that I can work with it and just get everything up together. And it's just straightforward wool palette sell point, and I've just brought it in and put it into the imported folder here that I created some time back for various other different mods that I've brought into this particular map. And you can see here we've got a wolf cell marker and an I3D, which is just literally the actual pallet cell trigger. So what I'm going to do here is just literally come in, find an area here, and I'm just going to go File, Import, go back to my desktop, Map, and then go into the Map, Imported, open up my wall cell marker folder, double click on the actual I3D, Edit, Interactive Placement, and I'm just going to bring it over and put it somewhere like so, so I don't have to go too far to actually demonstrate selling the pallets with the planks on. Okay, so now that I've got that into there, and I'll show you what I mean if I reopen my user attributes, click on this, go into the actual trigger itself, you can see here we've got an onCreate, which is the fillable pallet cell trigger dot onCreate, which is a Giants editor script. It's just basically pointing towards that script, which you would use exactly the same one as it states there to sell your wall pallets or any other pallets that you want to get rid of. So this would work for your greenhouses with the large greenhouses with the pallets and everything else that creates something on a pallet, wooden pallet. So there we go. Okay, so now that I've got that into there and I believe everything is set up appropriately, what I'm going to do now is actually come out. I'm going to save this because I've already put my trees down and everything, so that's good. So I'm going to save this, come out of it, and then I will go back to the desktop and we'll have a look at the mod desk and copy over some appropriate parts to get this hopefully all functioning and working properly. So I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so here we are back on the desktop, and I'm just going to, what have I got here? Yeah, so I'm just going to go into my map folder here and I'm going to open up the mod desk to start with for that. Don't need that. And then I'm going to go into the actual mod itself and open up the mod desk for that. And in here we've got some items that I need to bring over, some text and some extra source files and scripts and path file names and bits and pieces. So I'm going to start up here with the actual 110N text. And if you actually look through this here, we've got some text down the bottom, which is actually the SigaWork desktop. I'm probably pronouncing that completely wrong. I do apologize to anybody who speaks the language that this is in, probably German, but that's how I'm going to say it anyway. This is actually what you will see for your placeable version, the information that's displayed in the in-game store page. We do not require that because obviously we're placing it in through Giants Editor, so it will be on the map once you actually start a new game or whatever else. We will not be purchasing it. That is, that's just there solely for the in-game store. But the other items, the other parts of the text there, I do require. So I'm just going to highlight those, leaving this bottom one not highlighted. Leave that alone. And I'm just going to copy all of that, come over into my mod desk from my sample mod map here. And I'm just going to find an appropriate place somewhere down here below my horses that I brought in last time, create a couple of new lines, and then paste that in like so. While I'm here, what I will do is just tidy this text up a little bit because it's going to bother me otherwise. So we'll just tidy this up, make it look a bit neater. We'll do the same with the extra source files, just so it keeps everything structured and it's much easier to see what you're doing then at a glance. Okay, so now that I've got that tidied up like so, we'll just go ahead and save. Go back into the mod desk for the actual sawmill, placeable sawmill itself, the mod, and come down to our extra source files. Now, if you didn't actually have any extra source files, you weren't running any scripts, then you would need to highlight all of this and copy the whole lot. As I already do have some scripts running on my sample mod map, the only part of text I needed is just this piece in the middle. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight that and copy it. Come back over into my mod desk for the sample mod map. Come down to my extra source files. Create my new line and then paste that in. Okay, so now what I need to do is actually copy the script over and put it in a particular folder. Now it is obviously in the folder for the actual mod itself when I brought it in. So if I go into map, models, buildings, and then I go into my woodwork, you can see the Fabric script is just there. But I don't want to have this massive great long path file name in my mod desk if I can help it. So what I'm going to do is basically take that and put it into a different folder. But what I'm going to do is go back out, come into my map folder, and I've got this folder I created in a previous video called scripts. So what I'm going to do here is just copy that fabric script and put it into that folder like so. So now that that's in there, all I need to do is create that path file name in the mod desk. So I've got map and then scripts. And luckily I've already got that in my mod desk from a previous video that I did with the horses and everything else. So all I have to do in this particular case is highlight that, copy it, and then paste it in up there. But if you didn't already have it, then just simply type it in as you see it there. If you follow these instructions by putting the script in the same folder that I have and the same path file name and everything. But if you haven't, then you will just need to create and adapt your own path file name for the appropriate folder that you've put the script in. Perhaps you may wish to leave it in the original folder or the folder that it was brought into in the map. If you put it into map, models, buildings, and then woodwork, you could create your path file name in the mod desk to point towards the script in here. However you wish to do it, I'll leave that entirely up to you. Okay, so now that I've got that there like so, I'm just going to go ahead and save. In the mod desk here for the actual placeable version, there's nothing else I need in here at all, because this is all to do with the placeable version. So I'm going to go ahead and close that down. I don't need to have anything more in here. I've copied over all the relevant parts for this, so I don't need anything there. So I've already saved it, so I can go ahead and close all that down. Excellent. Don't need this any further, I don't believe. No, there's nothing in there I want, so I can go ahead and close that. And then in my map folder here, what I need to do basically is just zip all this up, and then I can put it into game, because there are no HUDs or anything like that, because in this particular mod version, whatever you do with the pallets are going to be either on a pallet fork or some sort of trailer that won't recognize the pallet anyway, so there'll be no appropriate need for HUDs and anything else, because there'll be nothing there for it to recognize to display one, so we don't need to worry about any of that. So now that I've got all that set up, like I said, I'm going to zip all this up, put it into game, and then I will get some money up together and some equipment, and we will cut some logs, cut some trees down, create some logs, and we'll get the sawmill hopefully up and running and go from there. So I will see you shortly once I get into game and get some parts up together to get this started. So see you in a little bit. Okay, so here we are now in game, and I've collected a few bits and pieces up together. I've got the Ponzi Scorpion King and a couple of tractors. I've collected up some wheat winrow just to get things fired up, so I don't have to mess around with creating wood chips. I've also got this trailer, wood log trailer here, which is an auto loader. I've only used it once before. It tends to work quite well. Just have to look at what side you're actually collecting the wood from, because it actually loads and unloads from the same pickup side, I believe. But we'll experiment with that in a little bit. So, okay, so first thing I want to do here is obviously start up the Scorpion King here, and I'm just going to come into my first tree, press B to switch it on. Anybody who's had to play around with this will already know how this works, but those that don't, so just come out, and we'll change that so we don't get that anymore. Okay, so just going to come into the tree, come down, and then what I will do is bring up the menu here, and I'm going to press the O key to change my cut length to the maximum for at least the in-game equipment to 8 meters. Then I'm going to press X to cut. I'll bring it out to the side here so that it is out of the way. And I'll press X to cut again, and we'll continue to do that until we get all of the appropriate logs here that I need to put on the trailer. So we'll just do this, do a couple more trees so we've got plenty to put into the sawmill. So just have to bear with me while I do this. Okay, I've chosen these particular trees because they are obviously, as you can see here, able to be cut down with this Scorpion King. Some of the trees in Giant Serta, you cannot, farmers in the game itself, you can't cut down with the Scorpion King, so you have to use a chainsaw, which can be a little annoying in my opinion. I'm not really that big into the forestry side of things on farming sim, but for those that are, this may be beneficial if you wish to get into using the sawmill mod in anything other than the placeable version. So yeah, Okay. So we'll do that, and we'll just do one more. I think one will be more than enough. We'll come over out of the way a little bit. So we'll just come in here like this. Here we go, do our cut. Whoops, didn't like that. Whoop, whoop. Okay. This is why I don't do forestry. It's got worse physics than the bales. Anyway, okay, so we'll just do this. Let's cut this one. So if I can I rotate the head around? No, of course I can't. Then we'll do that one there like that. That's more than enough. More than I want to play around with this. Like I say, I'm not really that big into the forestry stuff, but just wanted to play around with this particular mod I saw on the site, so I figured why not. But other than that, I generally wouldn't get involved with the forestry stuff. It just frustrates the hell out of me. But anyway, never mind. Moving on. So we'll come in with this one now. I'm just going to open up my menu here. So we've got B to start auto load, and it's going to load from the left hand side. We can see here we've got B to start auto load, and then we have Y to start unload and zero for left side, and that is, from my understanding, the side that it will load from and unload from. The M key is the Gatter Uz, whatever that is, and if I press that, it just gets rid of the head rack. That's all that is. So I'll leave that there for now. I'm okay with that. So we'll press B to start auto loading, and we'll come around. I want to be on the left side here, the wood on the left side, so that it picks it up. Hopefully when I come in here, there we go, it'll pick it up, put it on the trailer, bam, like that. Excellent. See how much more I can actually pick up. I don't know how much you can actually pick up with this thing, so be interesting to see. One more, a little bit more. See what we can actually get on here. Max it out. Or is it all going to fall off? Right, I think it'll just keep falling off. Anyway, so I'm going to turn the auto load off and then get out of here. So we'll go over to the actual sawmill now, and the trigger that this has got set up on it, it's very similar to the trigger that you use when you're selling your wood at the lumber yard, where you literally just drive through the trigger and the logs get sold off. Where in this case, logs don't get necessarily sold, but they do get placed into the actual mod itself and stacked up next to the conveyor system here. So there we go, perfect. You could always come along to the side if you want to be a bit more realistic, perhaps maybe come along to the side and then unload them, but it's an auto loader, so you know they're just appearing and dropping from the sky, so you know, realism's out the window at that point, I think. So for that part, I'm okay with that. So now I'm going to jump into this tract here, and as I said, I already collected up some wheat windrow, because if you remember right, this takes wheat windrow, barley windrow or wood chips. Like I said, I don't want to start messing around with creating wood chips, so I'm just going to use the wheat windrow and unload that into here just to get things fired up and moving along. So we'll put that into there. It probably won't take all of it now, I didn't think so. There we go. So that's in there like so. Perfect. So we'll come out, switch that off. And we'll come over and have a look. Okay, so it does actually show up as wood chips, but that's okay. I'm alright with that, because that's more than likely what I will be putting back in there anyway. Like I said, this hopefully will be somewhat self-sustaining. The byproduct that will come out of here, the chute, will be wood chips. So as they come out, I can collect them and then put them back into here to continue the operation. Now, I did actually find that you cannot reverse a trailer under this funnel tip trigger spout thingy. You have to use a wheel loader with a shovel or a telehandler or a front loader or whatever else. It has to be something with a shovel or bucket or whatever you want to call that. I'm going to call it a shovel. And then you put that underneath this funnel here, and it then will collect the wood chips into the shovel on the, in this case, wheel loader. It will not work with a trailer, a tipper trailer. You may be able to adjust that if you so wish to do so, if you don't particularly want to use this function, but I'm okay with that. Again, I could always empty it out into my shovel there and then have a trailer out here somewhere to tip it into if I wish to do it that way, and then transport the wood chips off to be sold elsewhere. But like I said, I want this to be somewhat, in my opinion, self-sustaining, so I would literally be taking them, collecting them from here, and then tipping them straight back into the process, the actual sawmill process, to keep the thing self-sustained and running on its own byproduct. Anyway, so that's that. So now we've got everything in there that we need. I've put in the wood chips, or straw in this case. I've put in the actual logs themselves. So if we come into the mod itself, and I bring up the F1 menu, come over to the info panel here, and you can see that we've got 100% on fuels, 97% on our logs. It's still showing fuels as empty at the moment because it does take a little while for the system to register and then run the script. Once that runs, we will then have things moving along and processing, hopefully, our wooden planks, and our pallet will appear and everything else. Just to get things going, I'm going to speed up time just to get it kicking off. There we go. So the logs go in. If you haven't actually seen this before, I'll come back along to the start here. So we have these like blades that come out of the ground here on this section, lift the log up, and then they go in, and the same process is repeated over and over again. So it comes out, the blades then disappear, the log comes down the rollers here, goes into the sawmill. We have our particle systems, fantastic, comes out the other side as a plank, magic. So then we come along and we have this sort of, I don't know what you want to call it, trampoline platform thingy here, whatever, and it just tips the planks and slides them across onto our pallet. Fantastic. So far so good, all working as intended. We come back in with the F1 menu up. We can see now we have wood chips at 2% and boards pallet at 8%. So what I'm going to do is actually speed up time a little bit again so we can get a full pallet here. Actually, what I will do is just come in here and have a look at the actual. So we have got 72, 81, 89, and 100. There we go. So it should now stop in a little bit because we're full up. There we go. So it stops. Okay, fantastic. So we've now got our board pallets completely full up, and that's that. So what I need to do here now is I'm going to actually, let's just get a skid steer, that'll be fine. Probably not the most appropriate because it's a little small, but it will do the job. So I will reset that back to an area I can collect it. We'll just come through, we'll put that in there with the other JCB, that's fine. We'll get this started up and I will move the boards pallet, whatever it's called, the pallet with the actual planks on. So come round, attach this up. There we go. Oops, mouse mat moved. Oh, I can't drive these things. Where am I? Over there. There we go. Right, so we'll just come over now, and then what I would do is actually take the boards pallet, or the actual pallet with planks, however you want to say it, and we'll then put it into the cell trigger, and we'll see what we get from that. So yeah, I'll see you in a little bit when I get over there. It's just taking too long. Okay, so I've finally managed to actually get over here at 13 mile an hour. So I'm just gonna try and line up here to pick up this particular pallet. There we go, and we'll just lift that up. There we go, magic. Right, and it starts away again, gives us our pallet, and we're back in business. So awesome. Like I said, it's not really probably the appropriate equipment to use, but it does work, so we'll go with it. And there we go, we sold. And if you look in the top right, we've got 8,320 for those planks of wood, so that's not too bad. I am playing on easy mode, easy difficulty mode, so if you're playing on medium or hard, then obviously that would be reduced somewhat, but whatever. I think, you know, irregardless of your difficulty mode, the return will probably be enough to make this worthwhile, in my opinion. Like I say, you know, you're cutting down trees, which for the most part, when you start a map, are going to be free because you won't have to buy them. And once you actually do get it running, your wood chips are going to be processed by the actual sawmill itself. So again, you know, self-sustaining, and you can take your wood chips from here. And that's not too bad. Not really in the right place. A little bit of adjustment required, but it'll do for now. It'll do. Like I say, you may have to play around with that a little bit to get it to look a bit more realistic than I have there, but that'll be fine for now. So what I'll do is I'll just jump into the JCB here, and we'll come under and collect some of our wood chips, and we'll see what that looks like. So if we come under, raise the bucket up a little bit, and there we go. We have our wood chips going in, so 3,539 collected. And then, like I say, I can just come straight over like now and tip those into the actual trigger here and fill that up. There we go. Probably won't take all of it. No, I didn't think so. So I can just leave that there like so if I wish to, and then that will just continually fill that up and keep the system all moving. So all I need to do there is just cut down some more trees, give it some more logs, and the process will continue until I decide I don't want to do it no more or whatever, I run out of something. So just have another look in here, so you can see we're still at 100% on fuel because just topped it up, 89% on logs, so it's used really not that many to give us one board pallet or one pallet of planks of wood, and we got, like I said, what was it, I can't remember, 8,000 something or other. So, you know, the profit there is pretty good, I think, in my opinion. Again, your difficulty modes are going to, your difficulty settings are going to make a difference on what you do get return-wise. You could always, perhaps, apply a price multiplier to this sell trigger if you so wish to do so, so it reduced what you were going to get from it, or increased it, whether you wanted to do that. But otherwise, I think, you know, it's perfectly fine as it is. It gives us what we need, and it looks pretty good, I think, actually. Not so sure about on this particle system animation here, but like I say, that's a bit of a foobar on the creator not putting that in the right place. Maybe it was an intentional thing. Maybe he didn't feel it was, didn't look right, and chose that didn't want it there, so he just buried it under the map. I don't know. Can't speak for the guy and his reasoning behind that, but you may be able to find a different particle system that would work for you, and then apply that accordingly. But I'm just going to leave it as it is. That's perfectly fine. That'll do. So there we go. The sawmill, as I said, this is one from the Two Rivers map. According to the description, I never played on the Two Rivers map, so I can't actually say that that's 100% accurate, but I can't see why it wouldn't be. All set up into the map, mod desk adjusted, scripts copied over and set up with path file names, particle system animations and all the rest of it, all set up. As you can see, we've got our wood chips flinging off the saw there. If we come around outside here somewhere, should be able to see, there we go, we've got the smoke coming out of our smokestack. So yeah, I think, you know, and the ground level was reduced there to make that look appropriate and everything else. I think that that's pretty, pretty good. So if you're into forestry and all the rest of it, and you're getting a little bit bored with the actual just cutting down logs and selling them, then this might be an appropriate sort of option to go down this road with the sawmill. And if you feel that, you know, the placeable version isn't working for you because the terrain is too uneven, or not enough room or whatever else, and you want to have a bit of a play around with Giant Senator and create some space and whatever else, and chuck this in through Giant Senator, hopefully this will help you out. So thanks very much for watching, and I will catch you on the next one.